I was out for a leisurely, relaxing, totally mundane walk in the park today, walking like anybody walks. And this girl came riding up on a bike right in front of me. And like, I have this cut on my ankle, and now I have pain right here. And I don't really know what to do about it, but this gets all tight, and I keep catching myself all twisted. So then my hip is doing weird things. My shoulder is doing weird things. Can't a girl just walk in a park?
All right, so we're going to go through D's stretches right now. And D is going to start with a little bit of a hip tilt here. And this is going to help to stretch out that, thank you very much, that front part of the leg. So we're going to get a good hip flexor stretch through here. We're going to get a little bit of a quad stretch. And I want to reaching across, so not just reaching up, but we're actually reaching over and across as well. You don't have to move like that through this. That's just her doing that. Great. Try the other side. So notice here that she's staying really nice and tall as she sets up. She's making sure to tilt that pelvis so we're not getting into that little bit of twerk. We want to make sure that we're trying to tilt the hips so that we're stacking nicely, shoulders on top of the hips. And as she's actually reaching up, she is, as you can see, reaching over. And that's going to get a nice stretch through that whole side. Nicely done. Do that a little bit more. I'm going to go. For the shin boxes, for most people, they might have a little bit of trouble getting into this position to sit upright like D is. So it is actually okay to support yourself with your hands behind you if you need to. But we want to make sure that we try to keep the glutes down. That's kind of the gold standard for this one. Am I right? Am I right? D, am I right? That's great. From here, we want to do a little bit of a turn over top of that front bent leg. And again, trying to keep the glutes down the entire time. Keeping the chest nice and tall. Reaching across as you can see D is. You can actually put your hand out front of you as well to support and walk yourself over, similar to how I was doing those child's pose. So now walk to the left towards that front knee D. There you go. Exactly. The whole time, butt stays down. If your butt's twisting up and off, not as good. Not as good. So just go to that comfortable point where you get that full stretch. All right, guys, now we're going to go into the figure four. So we're going into this internal rotation here. There we are. And this one, the glutes can actually come up and off the ground. But so let's start that again, D, and go back up into your figure four so we can show the nice people of the interwebs. Starting with a nice bent knee position here, bring the other leg up and over. Yep. And this is that figure four that we're talking about. Now we're going to let everything fall down towards the side. Yes. And feel that nice stretch. So her shoulders are staying down. She's twisting through the lower part of the spine and the middle part of the spine, trying to keep the shoulder blades on the ground the entire time. Just feeling out that nice stretch. So to lessen the stretch, foot closer. To more in the stretch, foot further. Great. So now D is going to go into what's called a supported airplane for the first of her three mobilizations. With this one, we want to make sure that we're going almost into a single leg deadlift or a single leg hinge. I still want her to be reaching back with the foot, trying to stretch out that foot. Right, exactly. So try to reach me, D. Try to reach back, reach that foot back, nice and long. Good. So from here, you can see she's already started the movement before I started explaining it, because obviously we set this up before and she knows what she's doing without me having to explain it, because that's all a setup. But what we're going to do here is actually have her, yes, exactly, open up the hips and then go down internally, rotate down into the hip there. So we're actually moving the hip socket over top of a relatively stable and neutral femur. And yes, we can actually, very, very true, in that movement, we can actually reach back with that to get a little bit more. If you're comfortable getting one arm off, reach that other arm up into the air. There you go. And then back and down. Support yourself as you come down. Yep. And so for some, that reach just lets you get a little bit more into that without twisting so hard through the back. First, she's going into child's pose first. Okay, let's talk about the child's pose first. We talked earlier about the child's pose being lateral, moving to the sides. But with this one, we're actually going to mix in the cat and cow as well, which was this exercise. Oh, you're supposed to be doing it. Good. So what we're going to do is while she's doing this, and you were already doing it, but we're going to talk about this just a little bit more. We're going to have you actually reach the arm across. Good. And so now as you do the cat and cow, you're getting more of a stretch through this side. Great. Great. Finally, for the last mobilization, we're going to do the half kneeling rotation. Half kneeling rotation is a really small and subtle movement. We want to make sure that the hips and the shoulders are always kind of doing the same thing. We can actually have the shoulders at the end range here go just a little bit further to get a little bit more of a stretch through the spine. But we want the hips to be opening over top of that femur again. So a lot of these exercises are all about making sure that we're using the body to move the hips on top of that femur and get different levels of stretch and mobility through there.
Femur, then pelvis, then femur. Then pelvis, then femur, then pelvis.
That's great,
then femur,
Dee.
Then pelvis.
Try the other side.
Then femur, then pelvis.
Great. Keep that up and give that a couple more twists. So you can notice that she goes internally as well with this, which is another way to really create some good rotational stretching and mobility. Good work, Dee. Okay, guys, so we're going to go through Dee's three strengthening exercises here. We're going to talk about a clamshell with rotation. So we're doing a side plank, full side plank here. Now this one to regress, if this is too painful, you can always go down just to that side there to do the clamshell as well. But with this, what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to go up into the side plank. So Dee's gonna show you the full Monty here. No bugs allowed on this mat, ever. Go up and go into your full side plank, good. Now go into your clamshell. What we're gonna add here is this rotational element where we're actually going to get good rotation through the spine, but we're also getting good hip rotation and core stability work through here as well. Isn't that right, Dee? Great. So again, if this is too intense, drop that hip. You can still do the same thing. You're still going to get a modicum of that effort in there while keeping that hip stable to the ground. Great, Dee. The next one we're going to do is the windmill, but doing it half kneeling. She's going to go into this half kneeling position. Does she really want her back foot there? She does. Great. So, and what that does for her is opens the hips. You'll see a variation of this one where people will have the knees more in line with each other, but this one is really allowing for her hips to open up to get that nice big stretch through there. It also allows you to be a little bit more stable through this movement as well. So as you can see, what's happening here is Dee is going to reach down towards the ground while keeping her core and glute engagement. Great. Good work. As you can see her pointing, she is lengthening, stabilizing. So not allowing, yeah, exactly. So core's maintaining that stability. She's staying nice and level between the shoulders and the hips through this whole entire movement. So as she showed, we're never stretching past. Great. Other side. Great. And last, we're going to be doing an oppositional Superman. No bugs! An oppositional Superman. And D is so long, she has to go on the angle for this one because she is so tall and so long. Now look how long she is. And as you can see, Dee's doing a great job of trying to swim away from me, but she can't get away because she's on the ground. Even though this looks like water, it's not. We want to make sure that we're engaging opposite glute to shoulder, pulling the hands up, straight arm, pulling the feet up, straight leg, and making sure we're not hinging through the low back, mid back here. So don't be hinging at the ribs and don't be hinging at the low back. If you feel strain and pressure through this part of the back, do check in on your core engagement. Great.
These are the recommended sets and reps for the segment you just watched. If you have questions, remember that we're here for you. If you like what you see, make sure that you support us on Patreon. Also remember to like, share, and subscribe to us on YouTube and check out our other social media platforms.
To make it more ridiculous this time,
okay.
Good luck.
Okay.
And go, this is take four, go.